Hi, and welcome to Castanet's Week in Review. I'm Nich Johansen with your top stories from this past week. A young person was arrested Wednesday after he allegedly made a threat against staff and students at the Kelowna Christian School that morning. Police were called to the school just before 9 a.m. after staff received the threatening phone call. Officers were able to trace the call and track down the young person. As a result of the threat, the school is under a hold and secure for most of the day, where students remained in their classrooms, but classes otherwise continued as normal. The specifics of the threat were not disclosed by the school or police. The man accused of robbing a downtown Kelowna bank in late January claims he doesn't remember the alleged incident. 48-year-old Jason Miles was arrested January 29th, after the TD Canada Trust on Ellis Street was robbed just after 1 p.m. Miles appeared in Kelowna court Thursday by video feed from the Okanagan Correctional Center, where he applied to have a psychiatric assessment done to determine if he can be found not criminally responsible by way of a mental disorder. In court, Miles' lawyer said his client, who's been charged with robbery and disguising one's face, doesn't remember the alleged incident at all. The snow kept falling across the Okanagan this week, resulting in crashes all over, but big powder days for skiers and boarders in the local mountains. High elevation mountain passes like the Coquihalla Connector got hit hard all week, as did downtown Kelowna, Penticton, and Vernon. The heavy snowfall pushed Big White over 600 centimeters of cumulative snowfall, putting it on track to surpass their total snowfall record, while Apex near Penticton saw more than 150 centimeters over the four-day period. Two 22-year-old men have been arrested in connection with a bloody assault in Penticton back in December. 31-year-old Kyle Bourdon was assaulted outside the Sage Pub before stumbling back into the bar, covered in blood. The scene was captured on the pub's security footage. Michael Jordan Shalagan Morset is now facing an aggravated assault charge, while another man from Peachland is also facing charges. The 60th Vernon Winter Carnival kicked off this week, with Queen Silver Star being crowned Thursday night. Megan Fowles was proclaimed the 60th Queen Silver Star. Carnival continued through Friday with local students chipping away during the ice sculpting event, followed by the annual parade on Saturday. Carnival will continue through next week, coming to a close on February 16th. That's it for this week's Week in Review. For Castanet News, I'm Nich Johansen.